Okay, without wasting any further time, let us start. Now, today's paper is Business Communication. Business Communication. Now, in MBA, this business communication is extremely important because if you do not have proper communication, you cannot be a successful manager. Okay. So, without say, before asking from you, let us give you a brief idea about communication, and thereafter I will start. Okay. First, let us ask from you. Say, Ria, your takeaway on business communication, or what do you, if I say ask you business communication, what do you mean by this term? Ria, are you audible? Ria Rajgupta?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Your takeaway on this term, business communication.
So, what to say in this?
No, what is your basic idea? Say, suppose you are a layman and somebody asks you, say, regarding your idea regarding this business communication. So, how could you define this term?
So, I don't have any knowledge about business communication.
So, basically, if I ask simple communication, how could you define the term communication?
So, communication means how we communicate with each other. It depends how we communicate with our family, how we communicate our with our friends, how we communicate with our relatives. And I think business communication refers to, I think, how we communicate with our colleagues. If we communicate with our friends like friendly, we cannot communicate with our colleagues like a friend. We have to maintain some, we have to maintain some professional manner in this.
Got it. I understand.
Okay.
Next, Shantoshi, your viewpoint on communication or business communication, how could you define this term? Shantoshi Singh. Your viewpoint on this term, communication or business communication?
Maybe it's in sharing of information between like each other about like giving knowledge about the business to like if I start any kind of business. Okay, so in any kind of business there should be employees and there should be other peoples also who are there who is involved in the business. So whatever we share like little bit information or any kind of suggestion which we give maybe to the employees is known as business communication.
Got it. This is your viewpoint and is more or less similar to Ria. Okay. Next, Shayori, your takeaway on this term, business communication. Yes.
Sir, communication is the term where we can share our ideas or feelings with anyone. And business communication means sharing some information between employee and the company.
So far, okay.
Business communication is a in a professional manner.
Okay. So far, if I can gist the main point, it is that you are saying communication means sharing of information. And it also means sharing of information among the business peers, isn't it? This is the crux of the discussion, isn't it? So far I have understood.
Yes.
Okay. Now, let me discuss my viewpoint. Basically, see, this MBA class it's a forum for discussion. It's a not to wrote anything or to mug up anything. Here, it's an open platform where we'll exchange our ideas. Not only that you learn from me, but if possible, I will also learn from you. It will be a reciprocal thing. Okay. So if you present any new idea, because you will be budding manager, if you present any new idea, and if I find it suitable, I will accept it. Okay. So basically, you can write the business communication, the term communication has come from the term commune. Just let me write it. Commune, it's a Latin word. It means something in common. It means something in common. From this, we have the term business communication. Then, how to communicate? The problem remains how to communicate. Then comes the term communication process. So how we communicate? Okay, you have shared your view, it is okay, but if we have to think in terms of a management professional, then there is some process. It's a communication process, a technical process, and we need to learn it. So first come number one, sender. Now who is the sender? Sender means the person who will pass on the information. Who will pass on the information? He is the sender. Then come the term message. Message, what do you mean by this term message? Means once the idea comes into your mind, you have this message. Okay. Here we are not saying that we are writing this message or we are framing word for word. Here we are saying that simply the idea has come into my mind and I have conceived that idea. The idea has just come into my mind and it is not properly written. I would emphasize that it is not properly written. It is called message. Means I have just conceived the idea, but it is not properly documented or I have not spoken. So it is simply an idea. It is message. Then comes the term encoding. Now what is encoding? When I am giving word to my message, means either verbally or through written word, it is called a message. Either it should be written word or it should be oral word, or I am communicating orally. Then this term is called encoding. Means I am putting word for this message. It is called encoding. Next comes channel of communication. What channel I will choose? Whether I will choose video channel or whether I will choose any telephonic media, or say I will use written form, that depends. So based on this, I have to decide my channels of communication. Say the thing what I am doing right now, I am taking taking net help and communicating with you through video conferencing. So this is the channel of communication. But say if I communicate with you over phone, it is telephonic conversation. If I write a letter to you, it is through written letter. Okay. Then comes receiver. Now for every sender there is a receiver for whom the information is made. He or she will receive the information. He will simply receive the information, but he won't understand. He will, whenever I am using the term receiver, means he is getting the information, but at that time he does not understand what is written, or whenever you are saying something to the receiver, what the sender intends to mean. Then comes the term decoding. Decoding means here the receiver will decode what the sender has meant to say. He will understand the thing, the intention of the message, what is written in the message, he will understand. So this process is called decoding. And lastly, comes feedback. Means the receiver will give a feedback to the sender and give the feedback that he has understood what the sender has meant to say. This comprises the entire communication process. Just go through it, what I have said, and after that, if you have any question, feel free to ask me. Any question till now? If you have any question, feel free to ask me, because as I have said, it is not your say MA or MCOM class, so it's a management class. Basically, our mode of teaching will be through discussion. We'll discuss, we'll use video medium, we'll use audio medium, and the purpose is to enhance your communication skill. Any question? If you have any question, feel free to ask me. So far, I have discussed communication and communication process.
So, can you please repeat what is communication?
Communication means exchange of ideas through communication process. And
sir, please be a little bit slow, please, sir.
Okay, got it. Communication means exchange. First, you can write also, communication means exchange of information. I am writing it here. First thing is, communication means exchange of information. Then comes how to exchange that information. That can be exchanged through following a process, and that process is called communication process. And communication process consists of the following element. Okay, the element that I have discussed means, first you should have a sender, means you. Suppose you want to communicate, say Riya want to communicate with Santoshi. So Riya will be the sender, and then comes the message. What is the message? Means what Riya has say want to communicate, the idea that came into the mind of Riya, that will be the message. Then comes putting word to that message, and that part is called encoding. Then the question arises, how to share the information. Here you have to select the proper channel of communication, and the proper channel may be, say, it may be video medium, audio video medium, or written word. Then comes receiver. Here Santoshi will receive the message, but he won't understand anything. He will simply receive the message. And then comes the process called decoding. Means here he will try to figure it out what Riya has said. This process is called decoding, and after that, Santoshi will give feedback to Riya that she has understood thoroughly what Riya intend to say or intend to mean. This constitutes the communication process. Just go through it for once. If you have any question, feel free to ask me. Till now, anybody, if you have any question, feel free to ask me. I will repeat again and again and again. Okay, so far I have understood that all of you have understood this thing. So, next sub part. Type of types of communication. Now, Shailu, you tell me, what are the types of communication? Because you people are aware of this term communication. Now, if I say, what are the types, then how to define this term types? Shailu Goshal, yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Communication, we can in various types, like in video communication or audio communication or written communication.
Okay, fine. Riya, you tell me, Riya Dasgupta, your takeaway on the types of communication. Yes, Riya.
Yes, sir.
Yes, your takeaway on the types of communication.
So, I think communication can be possible like video communication, audio communication, written communication, face-to-face communication. That's all.
Okay. Suresh, any idea? Suresh Mondal?
Yes, sir.
Can you add to this that say I am asking about types of communication? You people are aware of the types of communication. So, your takeaway on this term?
I think four types of communication: verbal yes. communication, non-verbal communication, written communication, and visual communication.
Partially correct. Chandrashi, your takeaway on this? Your viewpoint on this types of communication?
So maybe internal communication, external communication, and like that kind of communication.
Okay, please mute yourself. Okay. Just a minute. First one is verbal. Verbal communication. Now, whenever we use the term, there is a misconception that verbal communication means oral communication. You people think in that way, isn't it? Verbal communication means face-to-face communication, oral communication. You people think in that way, isn't it? Tell me. Give me your honest feedback. Whenever I am using the term verbal communication, you think that it's a face-to-face communication. Means you are speaking, isn't it? You are speaking another person and another person is listening. It is not so. Verbal communication are of two types. One is oral communication. What is oral communication? The thing that I am speaking. I am speaking and you people are listening. This is oral communication. Though I am using a video mode, but it is an oral communication. You cannot say it's a video communication. It is a conception, as per conception, it is totally wrong. It is oral communication. Because I am using video as a medium, no doubt, but what I am doing right now, I am speaking with you people, and you people are giving me feedback. So it's a oral communication. If you have any question regarding oral communication, feel free to ask me. Or if you have any doubt that why this video communication is not an oral communication or it should be a oral communication.
But that others can also speak and give feedback.
Yes, sir.
Only you.
No, yes, yes. Oral communication, as I have mentioned, that we people are communicating. We are using video, this Google Meet, as a platform. But we are, what we are doing, we are not writing anything. It is not a written word. We are communicating with you, isn't it? So that's why it's a oral communication. Then comes written communication. Because some people have a misconception that written communication is not a verbal communication. Because verbal means when you are speaking, that is verbal communication. It is totally wrong. Written communication also comes under verbal communication. So basically, verbal communication means oral communication and written communication. Written communication takes various forms like letters, memo, agenda, minutes. These I will discuss later on. So basically, these are the written communication. Next come nonverbal communication. Anybody? Shomo Shubhro, you tell me regarding this nonverbal communication. So
yes, sir.
Yes, your takeaway, yes, on this non-verbal communication.
Sir, I think non-verbal communication includes video communication.
Not correct. Suresh? Suresh?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Your viewpoint on this non-verbal communication.
Tone of voice, body language.
Body language is partially correct. Any other takeaway on this non-verbal communication?
This includes letter writing. Otherwise, telephonic communication is an example of non-verbal communication.
Not correct. See.
There's no body language and facial expression.
Partially correct. See, Shatadru, as you have said that telephonic communication is a non-verbal communication, it is not so. Because what is telephone? Telephone is a medium, that is channel of communication. And what we are doing over telephone? We are speaking. So that is communication. That is oral communication. So you cannot say it is a non-verbal communication. Isn't it? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So non-verbal communication mainly means body language. Now, what is body language? Any idea? Any idea regarding this term, body language?
Sir, that...
Yes. Shatadru.
Using...
Yes, sir. See, here we are all intent to learn anything. We are always there to learn something new. So, if you give me a concept and if it is acceptable to me, and I will accept it. So we are all here to learn something new. It's a brainstorming session. It is not like that I will speak and other people will listen. Everybody will participate in the discussion. So your takeaway on this body language.
Sir, expression, clothing.
Partially correct. Ria, your viewpoint?
Sir, to express oneself. Sir, to express.
Okay. Ria, your viewpoint?
So some non-verbal signals like... posture or facial expressions or hand gestures.
Partially correct. So there are technical names. In management you cannot say like this. So there are technical names. So first is posture. What is posture? Means how we stand or how we sit. That is basically a posture. Say, let us say, suppose take the example of an interview. If you are nervous in an interview, what will you do? You will clasp your hand, and what other thing you will do? Your shoulder will be down. So basically, people will understand, the interviewer will understand that you are very nervous and you are very aging. So this comes from your posture. But on the other hand, if you lean forward, see, I have an eye-to-eye contact with the interviewer and smile. So this gives a warm posture. Warm posture. So depending on posture, automatically the interviewer measures that whether you are confident or you are diffident. Diffident means you are not confident. So basically, how you express yourself determines your posture, means how you are sitting, how you are standing, say on the dais or say on any platform, that comprises the your posture and that exhibit your confidence level. Say if you are very, say what can I say, very nervous, then what you will do? You won't face the audience. People have the tendency, they won't face the audience. So what they do? Instead, say suppose the presentation is going on. So what the people will do? They will look at the screen and they will turn back against the audience. So it's a bad example of posture. It's an extremely bad example of posture. It means that you are nervous and you are not in a position to face the audience. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Next comes gesture. Now what is gesture? Gesture means either facial expression or any expression using your body parts. Basically, gesture is done through hand. Gesture is done through hand. Basically, there are various types of gesture, like one is called give. Give means just pointing, you are showing your hand, throwing your hand towards the audience that you are giving something. You are giving something. That is a form of give. Another is that show, means you are putting your hand on your chest and giving a kind of exclamation. Yes, I am showing this thing. This is the wonderful thing to show. This is show. Another is chopping, means just, what can I say, moving your, waving your hand in a fanatic way. Just chopping. Whenever you are, say, in an enraged mood, you are not happy with your, say, with the, say, audience or other people, then you will show this type of gesture. Other types of gesture are also there, like shrugging your shoulder or say what can I say, winking your eyes. Basically, making facial expression, either it may be happy or it may be funny, just to show that you are not happy or you are happy. Basically, communication, 55% of the communication is done through body language and rest is done through verbal, verbal communication. So non-verbal communication plays the most important role in business communication. Any question up to this, feel free to ask me.
So can you please explain chopping?
Chopping, it is means chopping. Suppose you are, actually my camera is not there, otherwise the camera facility is not there because I am recording OBS, through OBS software. So I cannot show you right now. So basically, just waving your hand in a fanatic way means you are disregarding, you are disdainful to the audience. Showing disrespect to the audience by waving your hand, by chopping. Can you have seen chopping means how to chop? Like that you are doing things.
Okay, sir.
Any other question? Next we will discuss forms of communication. Forms of communication, basically I will just touch upon one or two points, and after that we will have a discussion. We will recapitulate the entire thing. So basically, forms of communication, first is formal. Now what is formal? Whenever you are in an office, you cannot talk or speak with your boss in an informal way. Actually, I like to know from you, do you know the difference between talk to and speak with? Anybody? We are familiar with the word talk to and speak with. I am writing it here. Talk to, one expression, another, speak with. What is the basic difference? Can anybody tell me? We use this, what can I say, this phrase while communicating with the other person. So what is the basic difference between these two?
So speak with means, sir, to speak in a formal way, and to talk with means informally.
Actually, basically it's a misconception. Anybody who wants to add on something? Speak with means it is more formal, it is okay, but speak with means I am expecting that the other people will say something. It will be a two-way communication. It will be a two-way communication. I will speak and then the other person will reply. I will speak and I will assume that you will reply. That is speak with. And when I use the term talk to, means this will be a kind of one-way communication. Means I will speak and you will listen. Basically, you will be a listener. Got it?
Okay, sir.
Sir, please repeat. Can you properly please repeat it once?
Whenever I am using the term speak with, I believe that the other party will participate in the conversation. Means I will speak and he will reply. That is speak with. But whenever I am using the term talk to, can I talk to you for a second? Means I will speak, you will listen. I will speak, you will listen. Basically, I want to convey some information. I don't want you people to have a, what can I say, to reply to me, to reply back to me. Got it?
Yes, sir. Can you explain the formal
communication? Yes, formal communication and communication. Formal communication means between your boss, between your peers group, and between and with your subordinate. It may be upward means subordinate is passing on the information to his immediate boss. Subordinate is passing on the information to his immediate boss. This is upward. Then comes downward, means the superior is passing on the information to the subordinate. The superior is passing on the information to the subordinate. This is downward. Another may be lateral or horizontal. It's a communication between the peers group, means people having the same position. Got it? Any doubt, feel free to ask me.
Sir, what is the difference between lateral and horizontal communication?
Lateral and horizontal means the same thing. Means it's I am using the or. Means it means the same thing. Means it's a communication amongst the peer group. means person having the same position.
Okay.
Any question up to this? Then comes informal communication. And basically, whenever I am using informal communication, the term is called grapevine. GRAPEVINE. Grapevine means just like a grape, the communication is spreading. Means it's a rumor, concocted story, false story about your peers, about your boss, any other thing. Means you want to say, be bad mouth about your boss, criticize your boss, or criticize your subordinate. It's an informal communication and it has no validity. Whenever two people meet outside the office or in the canteen, they communicate. And this is called informal communication.
Sir, repeat.
Suppose you are Santoshi. After the class you meet and you are bad mouth about me, say criticizing my class. This is informal communication. This because you are not ventilating your what can I say, frustration or grievance directly to me or to the authority. But informally you are sitting together and what can I say, saying that we are not satisfied with the teaching and the teacher doesn't know anything about communication. This is grapevine or informal communication. Got it? So this is all for today's class. Basically communication comprises of reading, speaking, listening and writing. So I will focus on all these four parts. As I have recorded this video, I will post it on my YouTube channel. You can see the video and say you can, if you want to recapitulate, you can recapitulate. Okay. So that's all for today. Have a nice day. Thanks for attending my class.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.